Hi and welcome to Liz Cafe. It seems like the drama surrounding Omosh will not be ending anytime soon. The former Tahiti actor has claimed he gave his first wife, Mrs. Ngatia, two plots of land, but she still disturbs him. The Tahiti actor Omosh has accused his first wife, Mrs. Ngatia, of portraying him negatively to the public. This is after Mrs. Ngatia, whose real name is Judy Ashoka, said publicly that they have been separated for 10 years since Omosh married a second wife. Before their separation, they were married for 18 years. According to him, he's given her two plots of land in Denderu and Thika, but she still disturbs him. However, Mrs. Ngatia has denied the claims, adding that Omosh is trying to lie to the public to cleanse his name after the backlash he has received on social media. Omosh claims Mrs. Ngatia is a very difficult woman. It seems Omosh is not pleased that Mrs. Ngatia aired their dirty linen in public. Yesterday, Omosh was pranked into selling his new house Kenyans built for him, and he has been trending for all the wrong reasons. Omosh was ready to sell his house for 15 million Kenya shillings. According to him, Mrs. Ngatia went against an agreement they had and approached the media to accuse him. Mrs. Ngatia has two plots, Omosh claims. Omosh said that the communication between them is grounded since the mother of his children no longer picks his calls. We only talk if it's her who calls, but when I reach out, the calls go unanswered, Omosh said. In his words, the couple reached an agreement when he was on holiday in Mombasa that the new house would be occupied by the second wife. He added that Mrs. Ngatia was allocated two plots in Denderu and Thika, but she's refused to settle on them. I wonder if Mrs. Ngatia was supposed to self-occupy the land without a house built for her. Mrs. Ngatia is disappointed with her husband, refuting allegations that her estranged husband had made the public to try and clear his name. According to her, Omosh is unhappy that she came out with the truth and will do anything to pour cold water on the truth. Those plots he's talking about are his father's, and he's yet to be allocated. Ask yourself why he didn't let the well-wishers build his house on one of them. Omosh neglected his first family, and the back and forth allegations between the two comes from a recent expose by Mrs. Ngatia that Omosh neglected her and the kids after marrying a second wife. He had time for me and my children, but since the second wife came into the picture, he is always busy. I accepted her as my co-wife, but he forgot about us when they moved in together, she told Hira Minor, who's popularly known as Kamuhunjia. However, Kenyans offered to build Mrs. Ngatia a house, but on land they will buy for her. It seems like Kenyans don't trust Omosh enough to build his first wife a home in one of the pieces of land Omosh claims he has offered her. It seems like Omosh is trying to divert attention from himself due to the fact he almost sold his house for 15 million Kenyan shillings, and is trying to blame his first wife, Judy Ashoka, popularly known as Mrs. Ngatia, for his woes. What are your views about this? Kindly leave us a comment below in the comment section. Kindly like this video and kindly consider subscribing if you haven't done so. See you on the next video, and bye-bye.